Papua New Guinea, or PNG, is known as one of the world's best scuba diving sites. It's also home to some of the least spoilt and most exotic tribal cultures, and is still largely undiscovered.
Great.
One of the things any visitor to PNG must take into account is its reputation for violence. Tribal disputes do flare up, but pose little danger to visitors, if you take sensible precautions. You should avoid the capital, Port Moresby, and other main cities. Instead, head for the safer and much more interesting interior of the country. Places such as Tari, home of the Huli Wigmen, where as little as 60 years ago, no white man or woman had ever set foot.
Should I put my bag on this bus?
Yes, please.
Okay, I think that was a yes.
Okay, you go.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome to Tari, home of a Huli Wigmen country. From here to Amber Lodge takes a 45 minutes drive on a bumpy, dusty road.
I've been in small airplanes in small airports before, but never one that just basically had a shack and the whole community turns out to meet the airplane at the other end. It's a little bit intimidating really, because they just stand at the fence and stare at you. I'm just reading this book on safety. It does actually recommend that women don't travel alone in Papua New Guinea. I can sort of see why, but I've got the added benefit of having a few guys behind the camera to look after me. As soon as you wave to one person, they all wave back.
Quite hard to imagine as you drive through the peaceful countryside that it does have a violent side, but the evidence is there.
So what's that little sort of painted house on the side of the road?
That is a grave, a man who got killed by another clansman.
What happened?
He was killed for a payback. We had a fight 9 years ago. During that time, 7 men got killed. 8 men received the arrow in his eye, and after 9 years, relative and the parents.
Payback is the system whereby if a member of one tribe injures or kills someone from another, then the whole tribe seeks retribution against that individual, or if they can't find him, against anyone else from his tribe. Don't worry if you do come across a dispute, as they have no argument with you and will actually suspend their battle and let you pass by. To me, everyone seemed very welcoming.
Hello, Anna.
Hello.
Hello, nice to see you.
It's Willie, is it?
Yeah, Willie, welcome to Ambua.
Thank you very much. It's very nice to be here.
Thank you.
You look splendid.
Thank you. My way of life.
The wig, you made that yourself?
Yeah, from my hair.
From your own hair?
Yeah.
I don't think I have enough hair for a wig.
You're different, because your culture is different, your skin is different.
You live in a beautiful place.
Thank you.
My first impression is very good. Everybody's extremely friendly.
Thank you. Great.
After that long, hot, dusty drive on what, believe it or not, is the main road in the Highlands, it's quite a surprise to arrive here in Ambua Lodge and see extreme comfort. Now, I'm not going to be staying here tonight. I'm going down to one of the villages. So I have to take a sarong with me to cover up my legs. And because it's pretty high up here, it does get cold at night time, so I'm going to pack a sleeping bag as well. And that's just about all I need, I think. Pretty basic. Looks quite frightening when you see someone dressed like that carrying a big knife. As long as he's on my side, then I'm happy. Do you get a lot of foreigners, people like myself, coming to stay?
No, not many people are staying in the village.
Might be quite a surprise for them then.
Oh yeah, because these people here, they never seen their the white lady.
Really?
Come to the village.
walk in this jungle and stay with them.
They've never seen a white lady before?
No, they never. Well, they come here as a tourist, they know, but they never seen them, staying with them in the village.
Which way do we go, Willie? Turn right at the pig.
It's a good pig. When we want to marry it, we have to have at least 20 pig like that.
Oh, like a dowry?
Yeah,
when
dowry.
You give that to the
girl's family. Money is number two, pig is number one.
Where are we going to be eating tonight?
Over there where you see the smoke? They're having what we call a mumu. Put the chicken, vegetable, everything in the grand oven.
A mumu is a feast prepared for special occasions and cooked underground in a parcel of banana leaves, hot rocks and tin foil. Though to be fair, this is really just a concession to my delicate Western stomach. The men prepare and cook all their own food, as they won't eat anything that's been touched by a woman. In fact, Huli men and women, for the most part, live very separate lives. However, my different cultural background means I can be treated as one of the lads.
And are you, do you smoke or not?
No, but I don't mind trying. Do I just suck it in?
Easy.
Strong?
At least it made you laugh anyway. It made me cry. This is the bathroom in the jungle. Just decided I'd better get changed for dinner because you have to cover up your legs, particularly if you're a white tourist, for the evening. So I've put this, what they would call a lap on, which is of course a sarong, just anything that covers your legs really. Preparing for the mumu tonight. Hard to believe you bake this feast just under the ground in a couple of hours. So it's a special occasion, a special feast.
And when we have all the friends, and then we have a mumu like this, so you are our special guest here in the land of Huli.
Thank you, I'm very honored. After that delicious mumu, time to get some kip. I was expecting it to be really uncomfortable. After all, we are in the middle of a rainforest here, staying with the Huli wigmen. But Albert has vacated his house so that I can sleep here. Although I was told that women normally sleep separately from the men, and in fact the women sleep with the pigs. So I'm quite relieved really to have a room of my own. And even though I've brought home comforts like a sleeping bag and a sheet and things like that, I really don't need it because I've supplied this thick foam mattress. And it's really comfortable in here. It's pretty much everything you need. I should sleep quite well.
Next morning, everyone's up early to prepare for Sing Sing, an event of great pride for the village, and one for which everybody wants to look their best, including, as it turns out, me.
You like you're a member of our family. Like you eat what we eat last night.
Yeah.
You sleep with how we sleep. So then now you have to dress up as we dress. She said, you get yourself ready.
I'm ready. Am I allowed to look now?
Oh,
my word. It's the most unusual makeup I've ever had. I'm obviously extremely privileged to not just witness this, but to be part of it, to actually be dressed up like a Huli woman. And what's interesting, I think, is how anxious they are to pass on their culture. This is in absolutely no way being staged for us. This is what they would do anyway. We're just witnessing it, really. Even a boy as young as this, he can only be about 3 or 4 years old, he's being painted by his father in the traditional way so that he learns the customs and grows up with them. I think it's fascinating.
Puli traditional dress consists of brightly painted faces, skirts made of specially grown leaves known, believe it or not, as arse grass, and of course the wigs from which they get their name. These are made from their own hair, and they're decorated with feathers from the birds of paradise, which are native to this region.
We do this when we are happy. So whole community come together. So we do this. Even when we are celebrating a new year or Christmas, instead of we don't sing the Christmas carol, we do the singing.
So all these people, all this crowd has to stay behind the fence, and yet I'm allowed to be here. Why am I allowed to be inside?
Because you dress up in a traditional.
First time you've let a white woman take part.
That's right, yes.
I'm very honored. I've travelled all over the world, but I must admit that over the last 24 hours I've experienced the most astonishing culture. Perhaps it's because they only met white people like me relatively recently, that their culture's really been unaffected, and they're so proud of it. They really want to show it to you, and they really want to pass it on to the next generation. And perhaps it's shows like this that will preserve it. I really hope so.